Joining me now from Southern California, Chairman of the Stars and Stripes Forever PAC, John Philip Sousa IV. John, the Stars and Stripes PAC that you head has a specific goal in mind, and that is to target these swing states and target within the swing states minority voters, more specifically black voters. And you did very well in these states using a certain methodology in 2016 versus 2012, did you not?
We did. Thank you. Our results in states like Wisconsin and Pennsylvania and Michigan in turning out black voters for President Trump really ended up being the margin of victory for the president. We got a higher percentage of black and minority votes than really any presidential candidate Republican has gotten in decades.
Outperformed in 2016, Donald Trump, and maybe it has something to do with the candidate as well, by the way, we should note.
Absolutely.
Versus Mitt Romney in 2012, outperformed by almost 8%. And you're doing so in one way, in several ways, but one of the ways you're doing so is kind of returning to an old faithful, and that would be radio instead of television, which is obviously a lot more expensive. Radio is not quite as expensive, but still, you know, X amount of people still listen to terrestrial radio and other forms of radio. And so what you do is you get some pretty well-known voices in certain sectors of society, like Alfonso Rachel. I don't know who that guy is. I had to research him. I know who he is now. He sounds like somebody I should have on the program. But here's an example of a radio spot. Roll tape.
More blacks, Hispanics, and women have jobs than ever before. And unemployment is at its lowest point in 5 decades. There's still a lot of work to do, but progressives always make the government bigger and the economy smaller. They hurt everyone, especially blacks, Hispanics, and women. Just a little something to think about.
Love the music, love the music. And so he's a conservative activist. He's a voice for the community. And these are the ads that are hopefully helping Donald Trump in 2020.
Well, we're reasonably comfortable that they will. We're hitting subjects like abortion. We're hitting school choice, which is a huge one in the black community. You know, these liberals are very happy to send their own kids to private schools, but don't want the minorities to go. They want them to suck up the NEA education that's absolutely worthless today.
Your great-grandfather, would he be proud of you, what you're doing here? Would he approve, do you think?
I hope so. People have asked me many times, what party was he? And there's no official record. However, there are lots of records of his doing concerts with Republican organizations and no records of his doing concerts with the Democrats.
Well, he was born before there was, if I remember right, his birth date. Let me check here, 1850. Well, he was born right around the time the birth of the official Republican Party.
Yes.
And Abraham, he probably voted for Abraham Lincoln. Maybe you can find out and let us know. Either way, Stars and Stripes Forever PAC.org, Stars and Stripes ForeverPAC.org, if folks would like more information and maybe help out your cause. John?
That would be great.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.